So good morning dear children, again I am here with lesson number 3, that is starting and shutting down a computer. So today we are going to study about the how we can able to start a computer or how we can able to switch on a computer. As we all know that computer is a machine that works with electricity. It works better and longer if we will use it very carefully and properly. So to switch on the computer we need different parts. When all the parts are connected together then only we can able to start a computer. So first today we are going to study about the parts of a computer. What are the different functions that parts are performing, and then we are going to study that how we can able to start a computer, and when you will start a computer what are the things you can able to see in your desktop or laptop, that we are going to study today. So now we'll study about how we can start a computer, but before that we'll study that what are the different parts of a computer and how the functions are performed with the help of that parts of a computer. So the topics which we are going to study, that is parts of a computer, how to start a computer, next is what is desktop and what is icons. So first we'll move to parts of a computer. As we all know that we have 4 basic parts of a computer, that is monitor, keyboard, CPU and mouse. These are the 4 basic parts of a computer that performs all the functions. CPU is the brain of a computer, and by the help of CPU all the functions of computer are getting performed. So now I'll show you the parts of a computer. We have different parts of a computer also. The first one is monitor, CPU, keyboard, mouse, speakers, UPS, printer, headphones, scanner, pen drive and web camera. All the parts are having different types of function. All these parts are divided into input device as well as output device as well as processing device. The device which gives us result we called it as output device. The device which we use to input data or information to the computer we called it as input device, and the device which performs all the operations that comes under processing device. In this parts of a computer we have pen drive also, and pen drive comes under storage device. Storage device means the device in which we can store our data. So like this we have different parts of a computer, but from all this we have monitor, CPU, keyboard, mouse. These are the 4 basic parts of a computer. Now in this you all are seeing that we have UPS. UPS also is a part of a computer. By the help of that we can perform our work in computer without any disturbance or any, if any electricity cut is there then also for some time we can able to perform with the help of UPS. So now we'll study in detail that how to start a computer. We all know the parts of a computer. We all know that computer works with electricity and we can perform all the tasks very easily and quickly, but when we are using computer we have to be very careful so that we can use our system for longer time and we can perform all the operations very quickly. So before starting we have to learn that how to start a computer. So first step is that whenever you want to start a computer, the first step which you have to follow, that is switch on the main power supply button. In this picture you all are seeing that boy is pressing the main power supply button because all the connections are connected with the main power supply. So from here when you will switch on the power supply button, the connectivity of electricity will get to the computer. Now the second step which we have to do, that is the first step we have learned that we have to switch on the main power supply, that is switch on the main power supply button. Now we'll move to the second part, second step, that is we have to switch on the UPS button. If computer or a laptop, if we are connected to a UPS, then we have to press UPS button, because UPS will help, because all the wires we are connecting with the UPS, if we will not press the button of UPS, computer will not start if it is connected with the UPS. So we'll press the button of UPS, that is uninterruptible power supply. So now second step is switch on the UPS, uninterruptible power supply. Now third step to start a computer, that is switch on the power supply button of the CPU. You all can able to see that boy is pressing the button of CPU. So the third step is that we can switch on the power supply button of CPU, that is central processing unit. It is the main device of a computer where all the operations are performed. So when we'll press the CPU button, again we'll get the connectivity of two CPU connectivity to keyboard and mouse. So the third step is that switch on the power supply button of the central processing unit. Now fourth step which we have to do, that is finally we have to press the button on the monitor screen. You all can able to see that Roy is pressing the button of the monitor screen. When you will press the button of the monitor screen, then you have to wait for few seconds. That few seconds means the booting time of the computer. As soon as you follow all the four steps, and the fourth step, when you will press the button of monitor, you have to wait for some time to start a computer or a laptop. So this waiting time, we called it as a booting time. When the computer will boot, it will show like this. It's showing that computer or a laptop is getting start. It will show that starting Windows. In at this time, all the operating systems include all the softwares which are already installed in your computer, that is getting loaded when you will press the button of monitor. All the things are getting loaded. This time is known as a booting time. It is a type of sequence or action done by computer. Now the fourth step is finally we have to press the button of the monitor and then wait for a few seconds. So these all four steps when we will follow, we can switch on the computer. The first one is that we have to switch on the main power supply button. Second is we have to switch on the UPS button. Then third step, we have to on the power supply button of CPU. And the fourth step is that we have to finally press the button of monitor screen. Now till here, when you will start, after taking the booting time also, the final screen which you will see on your desktop or a laptop, that is known as desktop. So after getting started, computer will look like this. Your computer screen will look like this. And the first screen which we see when we start a computer, that is known as desktop. Desktop is the first screen we see when we switch on the computer. All the icons are displayed on the desktop. You all can able to see that we have small labeled pictures on the desktop. That pictures are known as icons. We have various icons on the desktop and all the icons perform different function. This small labeled pictures are called as icon. We have various icons present on the desktop. You can able to see that is libraries, computer, recycle bin and internet explorer. All this perform different tasks. Like computer, when you will click on computer icon, you can explore the window of computer. Recycle bin will show you that whatever things you are deleting from your computer, that is getting saved in the recycle bin. If you don't want from their recycle bin also, you can delete it. But again, if you want by mistake you have deleted something, you can again restore it to the particular place. This recycle bin works like a dustbin of a computer. As we throw all the waste in the dustbin, in the same way, whatever we don't want in our computer or laptop, we can able to move it to the recycle bin. And Internet Explorer, with the help of this Internet Explorer browser, we can able to browse internet. So these all are the different types of icons. So till here we have completed about that, how to start a computer, what are the things we have to follow, what are the steps we have to follow when we switch on the computer, what is desktop and what is icons. So now I hope it's clear to all of you that how we can switch on a computer, what is CPU and what is UPS, and what are the functions we can perform on our computer, that is desktop or a laptop. What are icons and what is a desktop? Thank you.